Hi, welcome back to a new workout. Today we're going to do an intense HIIT cardio workout. There are no repeating exercises or sets in the workout and you don't need any equipment. So get ready and let's start. Okay, here we go, starting this workout with a short warm-up before we go over to the main exercises of today. First of all, just step the toes in front of you and curl and extend your arms. Don't speed up in that warm-up, but make sure you're ready for the main workout, because today that is an intense HIIT cardio. We do three different rounds, no repeating exercises, five exercises in the first round, another five in the second, and the final five in the final round, the third round. And of course we finish with a cool down. So make sure your muscles are warmed up a little bit, your heart rate is up, prepare yourself. Just keep tapping your toes in front, curl your arms. We do five exercises in that warm up and then we're ready. We go straight into the first round. Final steps. And then we're going to do some side steps and swinging the arms up and down. Just follow me along. Go over to the side steps right now. So we swing one arm up, one arm down. That's it. Half circles with your arms, one up, one down. To get the heart rate up, loosen up the shoulders a little bit, get the blood in the arms. No jumping exercises are in the main workout. There are some knee bends, but you can do them straight up. I will show you the options. So you can do this half workout on your own fitness level, on your own pace. So just follow along. Swing your arms up just a few more seconds. And then we're going to warm up the lower body some more. Swing, right up, left up. That's it, final ones. And come into a wide stand. Going to do the hip circles. Pop the hips out to the side, front. Lean back a little, stretching up your hips. And then pull your butt back, feeling the stretch in your hamstrings a little bit. So rotate and move your upper body along. That's it. And of course, we're going to reverse those circles. And we're going to do that right now. Reverse. From right to left, press forward, lean back a little. Loosen up the hips. Up. Just a few more. Now we stick to the lower body and we finish with the upper body. So circle, two more, and the final one, that's it. Shake it out, and now we're going to do the knee skip. So we pull the knee towards the chest, and bring that heel towards the butt, kick back. That's it. And you don't want to speed up, just focusing on pulling that heel up, knee and heel back. That's it. Knee up, skip it up, and back. That's it. Big motions. Up. Up. Just a few more. And then one final exercise in the warm-up. And then we're ready to go. Speeding things up. Getting the heart rate up in the main workout. After every five exercises, you have a water break. And we do each exercise 50 seconds on. And we just have 10 seconds rest to re-get your breath a little bit. And go over to the next exercise. Final skips, left, right, and one more on each side. Skip it, and that's it. Okay, the next one is the shoulder rolls, big ones. Up, that's it, rotate the shoulders, bring the arms out a little bit, shoulder blades together. While making the steps, slow pace, that's it. And reverse the rolls to the front. To the front. A few more, and then over to the main exercises. First round. Final round. Rotations. Up. And that's it. Shake it out. And take a short sip of water if you want to, because we're going over to the main workout. 5 different exercises, 50 seconds on and 10 seconds active rest. The first exercise, the floor taps, we're twisting in from side to side. If you can go down that low and you have knee injuries, just stay up and twist in, tapping your knees. So don't go down if you can't. Get ready, because there you go, starting down, up. Twist over, side to side. 5 exercises in the first round, 50 seconds. So adjust your pace, but now is the time to get a heart rate up. So speed it up if you can. Stay active. Touch the floor with your fingertips or your knees if you choose the high option. Up. Come on, twist it in, side to side. Come on, 15 seconds left. Stay down low. And just a few more. Twist it in. And that's it. Come on up. Shake it out. Take a deep breath in. Don't stand still. Stay active. The next one, cross crunches. Come on, bringing the elbows towards the knees. High knee march. Up. And your right elbow is going to your left knee, left elbow to your right knee. That's it. And lift your knees up high. Your upper body is just crunching a little bit to the front. Most important, twist in. Working your core, making that high knee march. That's it. Keep the heart rate up. You're doing great. Up, twist it in. Left, right, left, twist it. Final 10 seconds. And the last ones. That's it. Lower down. Stay active. The next one is an out step. Come on up and out. Just a slight knee bend, not too deep. Just enough to pump the heart rate up. So step it out, up. Up, up, and of course if you can do that knee bend, just stay high up, step out, and move your arms all on, come on, curl, curl, left step out, right step out, that's it, just a little pulse to pump up that heart rate, that's it, come on, power in your arms, curl, step it out. Up, 15 seconds left, that's it, come on, and right, left, right, 5 seconds, don't quit, out, out, and that's it. Okay, 2 more exercises in the first round. You're going over to the crisscross steps, so you're tapping over, arms stay up, there you go, left, tap it over. Tap it over, up, in and out. Bring your hands towards your chest, shoulders low, chest up, and then just bring that knee up, tap it over, in and over, in and over. That's it. Power in those legs, come on, tap it and lift that knee up. Your arms stay up, head shoulder high, only tapping your chest and extending those arms again. 20 seconds. Come on, tap it over, tap it over. High knees, 10 more seconds. Out and over, out and over. And just a few more. Come on, active, final one. And now lower your hands down. Final exercise already in the first round. We finish with a fast dribble. So we dribble, fast feet. So come on. Move your arms like you're running real fast. And just lift up your feet just an inch above the floor. Hop, 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 hop. Come on. Keep that heart rate up. It's the final exercise before the water break.
So dribble, 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 and move your arms. Engage your abs, up. That's it, power. 20 seconds left. Come on, fast feet, as fast as you can. Dribble, dribble, dribble. Hop, 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 hop. Come on, don't slow down. Final 10, speed it up. Come on, sprinting to the end. 5, and come on, that's it. Okay, you finished the first round. Now have your water break, and then I see you in the second round. We do 5 different exercises. Okay, here you go for round number 2, 5 different exercises. We start with the tap back, lunge position, tapping the floor. If you can't go that down, up, then stay up high. Choose your option. There we go. Come on, to the floor, tap it back, or stay up high, tap back, and tap your knee. Choose your option, but the deeper you are, the more you have to pump up and down, and the harder your heart rate get up. Up. Tap it down. Touch the floor with your fingertips. We go 50 seconds on, 10 seconds active. 5 exercises. So come on, tap it back, tap the floor. Up, keep going. Or stay up high, tap your knees. Choose your option, but stay active, don't quit. 10 more seconds. Tap it back, up, floor, floor. Almost there. Come on. Final one. That's it. Okay. Take a deep breath in. Stay active. The next one is a leg lift in front. We tap our legs. So come on, follow me. Lift. Lift. Hop. That's it. Swing your arms over. Tap your leg. Swing as high up as you can. But keep your upper body straight up. So your shoulders stay above your hips. So do not bend over to tap your legs. Just stay up high and swing your legs up. As high as you can. Come on. 20 seconds left. Lift it up. A little bit higher. Yes, you can do it. Come on. Bring those legs up. Work your lower abs as well. Final 5 seconds. Don't quit. Stay active. And that's it. Well done. The next one is a double low step. If you can't go down, just do a double high step. So come on, double. Cross and pull your arms. Hop. Stay down low, just a little bit. Feeling that burn in your quads. Your glutes, and of course a little bit of the outer thighs. Come on, move your arms with power. I'll stay up high, do a double. Power in your arms, that's it. Come on, hop, hop, challenge yourself. Double left, double right. Stay down low if you can. 10 more seconds. Hop, double, almost there. To the left, finish to the right side. And now coming up. Shake it out, catch your breath. The next one is a step over. Imaginary wall in between your legs, so step it over. Lift up your knees, hop, hop. That's it, side step. But we're the high knee raise. Hop. Power. Hop. Over that wall. Step it over. Step it over. That's it. You've got it. And that wall isn't lowering down. So keep the knees up. Up. 20 seconds. Step it over. Hop. That's it. Great job. Don't slow down and keep the knees up high. final ones. Up to the left, step over right. One more time back, and that's it. Over to the final exercise of the second round already. What we're going to do is star jack. So we're stepping to the side and step out. So come on, up, up. Arms are going into a V shape up. Stepping from side to side. Stay up high. And because it's the final exercise of the round, try to speed it up. Really get it high rate up. Step it out. Slowly keep the knees bent, don't lock it. And make big steps. Arms up and down. All the way up, all the way down. That's it. Come on, 20 seconds left. Then you have that water break again. Hop. You can do it. Step it out. Left and right. 10 seconds. Don't slow down. Come on, keep up that pace. Hop. Left, right, final ones. And that's it. Okay, you finished. Round number two. Now have another water break. And then I see you in the third and final round. We do 5 new different exercises and we finish with a cool down. Okay, ready for the final round? We start with the windmill taps. We're stepping out, touching the floor. And again, if you can't touch that low, then just step out and have that hand between your legs. No problem at all. Ready and go. Tap it out and touch the floor. Slowly bend the knees. You don't have to twist. Up. One arm up, one arm is touching the floor, or as low as you can get. Come on, it's the final round. So give all you've got left. Bring that heart rate up for the final time. Up, left, right, left. Step it out, touch the floor. Bend over. That's it. Come on, bump it up. 20 seconds. Up, right and left. Right and left. Don't quit. Keep it up. 10 more seconds. Left to right. Up. Touch the floor. Just a few more. Left. Right, final ones, and right, come on up. Okay, stay active, take a deep breath in. The next one, side crunches. Lifting the leg up to the outside. Okay, ready, go, up, up. So the knees are out, bring it up, and you crunch that upper body from side to side. Up, that's it. Lift up. Wide stand. Bring the knees up and touch the knees with your elbows. Bend that upper body. Halfway, come on. That's it. Working your core as well while keeping that heart rate up. Left and right alternating. 15 seconds. So come on, bring the knee up. Bend that upper body. That's it. And just a few more seconds. Don't quit. Keep lifting, final ones, and that's it. Great effort. 3 more exercises. The next one is a side lunge with a leg lift. If you can't bend, just step and lift. Come on, hop, lift, lift. Don't have to go deep, just do that pulse and lift it up. Swing your arms, and we stay on one side for 25 seconds. Then we switch over. Up. Step it out, pulls up. Up. Okay, we're going to switch right now. So stepping to left and swing. Up. 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 That's it. Come on, pump it up. That's it. Keep that heart rate up. That's the most important. You don't have to go deep, just a little pulse so you can swing that leg up. 5 seconds left. Keep it up, up. Last one. That's it. The next one is a heel tap jack. So what we're going to do, hands up. We're tapping the heels behind our back. So hands up, there you go. Tap your heel, hop, hop. Or your toe, or the feet. If you can't reach it, just curl your leg and bring that hand up and down. Come on. Knee slowly bend, upper body straight up. Lower that arm, tap it. That's it. We're halfway. Come on, kick your butt, curl that leg, and keep your arms up. Only lower that hand down to touch your feet. Up. Keep it up. And 15 seconds. Yes, you can do it. Up. Left and right. Left and right. Final seconds. Up. Almost there. Last ones. And that's it. Final exercise. We're going to speed things up again. We're going to jog in place or just march, whatever you want, and making jabs. Hop, hop, hop. Come on. That's it. Hop. It's the final exercise. So jog in place or just march as fast as you can and punch it. Punch with power. Upper body is straight up and engage your abs. Come on, pull the belly in. Punch, 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 punch. That's it. Halfway. It's the final one. So don't slow down. Keep up the pace because you're doing great. Come on. It's the final one. 15 seconds. Up, up, up. Keep on punching. Dribble, dribble, dribble. Marching in a spot. Up. And final five. Come on, speed it up. Up, up, up. And that's it. Very well done. Okay, now don't stand still, but slow it down. Take a deep breath in and out. And another one. In and out. That's it. And now when you're ready, just step and swing your upper body a little bit from side to side. But most important, lower that heart rate down. So if you just want to do the side steps, it's fine. Lift up your chest, shoulders down low, make yourself long, and take deep breaths in. If you want to swing to release tension, it's fine. You can do whatever you want, but don't stand still, and just take that time to recover before we're going to do some stretches. That's it. Feeling better already. Up, swing over. From right to left, or just stay to the steps. And that's it. Okay, ready to stretch the spine. We did a lot of twisted, and you need to engage your abs with a lot of moves. So time to release the tension. Walking off, twisting over to the left side. Place your one hand in your lower back, and then twisting your upper body. Try to keep your hips still, watching over that left shoulder. And feel that stretch in your abs, in your spine. Upper body is straight up and then twist it. That's the move. Feel the stretch in your abs, a little bit in your lower back. Watching over your shoulder as far as you can. And then release. Swing 2-3 times and then we do the same stretch on the other side. So place your right hand in your right lower back. Watching over that shoulder, press your hip front and your shoulder to the back. Follow it over. Lift up your chest, make yourself long, and feel that stretch. Just hold it a few seconds. And that's it, release. Make a few swings, releasing the tension out of your core. That's it. And now stretching the lower body. We did a lot of low steps, or if you just stayed up high, always your legs are working. So time to stretch the quads. Find your balance, pull your heel towards your bent knees together and press that knee, pull that knee back, press the hip forward. You can feel that stretch on your quad. Don't lock that standing leg. Never lock your knees up, just keep it slightly bent. And release over to the other side, find your balance. Grab your right leg right now. Knees together, pull it back a little bit, hips forward. Till you can feel that stretch on your quadricep. If you have to pull it more, just do it, but feel that stretch and don't bend over because then the stretch is too intense. That's it, straight up. And just pull as hard as you need to feel that stretch. And then release, shake it out. The next one, feet on hip width, hands above your knees, and we're going to rotate the knees and the ankles. So move your feet over from the side to side to the toes, rotating your ankles, your knees to release the tension out of your joints and your tendons. That's it. And reverse to the other side. Just nice and slow circles. Not too fast. Just releasing all the tension out of the lower body. And we do a few more. And the last one. That's it. Now come into a wide stand. And we're going to fold over. If you can, stretch out your legs right now, because we're going to have that stretch feeling on the inner thighs, your hamstrings. So bend over as far as you can, so you can feel that stretch on your legs, your hamstrings, the back of your legs, and your inner thighs. Just stay center, and then move over to your left feet. Try to grab them with your hands, or just grab your knee if you can, and pull your upper body a little bit closer towards your knee, so you can feel that intense stretch in your hamstrings and your inner thigh on your left side. And then releasing over to the other side, doing the same stretch on the right. Pull your upper body close towards your knees, feeling that stretch on the inner thigh and your hamstring. That's it, hold a second. And then back center. Try to bring your chest closer to your legs. If you need to, pull on your calves to bring that upper body closer. And then bend the knees, roll up, roll up, roll up. And that's it. Very, very, very well done. Because you finished an intense HIIT cardio workout. No repeating sets, 3 intensive rounds with cardio exercise. So be proud of yourself that you finished this workout. Give yourself that well-deserved thumbs up. And of course, I wish you a great day, and I hope to see you next time in another workout. Bye.